what you see in this picture is channels that could have been dug out by streaming water. And we know that at this moment, streaming water is, so liquid water is not possible on Mars. So the climate of Mars must have been very different in the past, and a large climate change took place. And it's very, very interesting to see when that happened, how that happened, and why it happened. And then there's to inspire. I find this a very inspiring image of a very small astronaut next to a very big rock on the moon. If we can really send humans to Mars, it will inspire a whole new generation of young people to study engineering and other technical topics. And well, we all know that this is very, very necessary in this world. And I even think it will bring, if we can send humans to Mars, it will bring all the people on Earth a little bit closer together. So is this really technically possible? When I started Mars One a year and a half ago, I had already done a lot of technical research. But when we decided to go deeper into this, we designed a mission that was possible using only existing technologies. So no nuclear reactor, no large planetary landers that don't exist yet, just technology that is already existing. And we contacted the suppliers, so the big aerospace companies around the world that make those components, and we explained them what we want to do, how we want to do it, how we want to finance it. And we visited them, we had meetings with them, and we discussed the components that we need from them. I'll quickly go through the components that we need for this mission. A very important one is the launcher. The launcher will be delivered by SpaceX. You probably all know SpaceX. It's the company that delivered a Dragon module to the International Space Station a couple of months ago and brought it back safely to Earth. The first commercial